Hello and welcome back to the next episode of the Full Stack Blog Application Tutorial. In this episode, we're going to do some major fixes, improving our code organization and our application performance. As you can see, I already started our development server, and I also started our microservice. And in Chrome, I opened up the website, and I also opened up our database. So the first thing we will do is we will split our route handlers into separate files. To do so, open up app.js. And the first thing we want to do is we want to create a separate file for our home handler. To do so, we can cut out this function, just like this. And then we want to create a new folder within our frontend directory. And the folder is called views. And within this folder, we're going to create a new file, and it is called home.js. In this new file, paste the copied code. And now we're going to give the function a name, and the name is home. And then, in order to use the home function from our app.js file, we can simply type export and curly braces and type home here. Now in our app.js file, we can simply import home from .views/home. Now in our home handler, we can simply pass home as route handler. Save the file and check if it worked. And as you can see, it worked. So let's do the same things for our signup and for our login route. So go to Visual Studio Code and create two new files, namely signup.js and login.js. And we can close home.js and again cut out the function code. Then paste it in login.js. Again, give it a name. I will use login. And then we can export our login function. Let's do the same for the signup. So again, cut out this function. Then paste it into the signup.js file. Again, give it a name. And again, export it. Save the file, and within our app.js file, we can now import our other views. So let's import login from .views/login. And also import signup from .views/signup. And now we can pass our functions as route handlers. So on the login route, we want to pass login, and on the signup route, we want to pass signup. Save app.js and let's have a look at the result. As you can see, our pages work, but the navigation doesn't work anymore. If we click on login or sign up, we get an error because the router is not defined. In order to fix this error, we must export our router. So let's type export default router in our app.js file. And within the home.js file, we want to import the router. So let's type import router from .../ in order to go to the parent directory app. Then we can save it and test if it works. As you can see, it doesn't work because we can't import the router. And I think we aren't allowed to export our router down here. So let's export the router directly after creating it. And let's try it again. And it still doesn't work. So maybe we have to remove the default here. And as you can see, now it works. And maybe we are even allowed to move it down now. Let's try it out. And yes, it works. Great. So as you can see, when we enter our page for the first time, it is loaded. And then when we navigate between pages, it isn't loaded anymore. So even if I go to a new page, our site doesn't have to reload, as you can see up here. But there is one exception. So if I log in as John42 and with the password example and hit login, we get this login request is not defined error, and it is because we haven't imported it in our login.js function. So let's fix this bug. So here we don't need the login request, sign up request and auth user request anymore. So let's delete this and then let's copy the import line. And as you can see, the auth client isn't used here, but we want to export it. So we export router and auth client. Now in login.js, we can import our auth client. So let's type import auth client from dot dot slash in order to go to the parent directory app. Now we can save it. And as you can see, the auth client is used to log in and then to decode the JSON web token. Now we can test if the login function works by logging in as John42 with password example, and let's hit login. And as you can see, we still haven't imported the login request, so let's do it. So let's type import login request from dot dot slash proto slash services underscore grpc underscore web underscore pb. Let's save the file and let's retry. Again, John42 and example, and let's hit login. And as you can see, we also haven't imported auth user request. So let's import login request and auth user request. And let's save the file. And let's retry, hopefully for the last time. And hit the login button. And as you can see, we don't get any error. So if we now go to our homepage, you see we're logged in as John42 and our email is john@gmail.com. And here's the problem in our application. If we hit the logout button, our page will reload. I can show you, so watch this corner. And if I now hit logout, you can see the page reloaded. And this is because we're using in home.js and we're calling, where is it? Here, window.location.reload. This makes our page reload. But actually, we don't want to reload our page. We just want to re-render our home page. So we can simply call home here, or just call the function itself. And let's save it. And now we can try again by logging in as John42 and the password still is example. Let's hit login. Now we can go to our home page. And if we now hit the logout button, the page is redrawn, but the page isn't reloaded. So we're only rendering the new HTML, but we don't fully reload the page. Great. The next thing I want to do is redirect the user after login and after sign up. To do so, open up login.js, which is here, and let's find our signup handler. And let's find the login handler. So this is the code which will be executed when the user successfully logged in. So at the end we want to type router.navigate and we want to navigate to the home page, so just pass a slash here. Then save the file and let's try it out. If we go to login, and here we type John42, and his password again example. And if we now hit the login button, we can see we're automatically redirected to our home page. So let's do the same thing for the signup page. Open up signup.js, and again, here's the code which is executed when we signed up successfully. So let's simply type router.navigate slash and save the file. Great. The next thing I want to improve is the performance on our backend. So close all the open tabs and then open up backend, auth service and service.go. So this login function is called every time a user tries to log in. And as you can see here, we always get the collection. But this is a very expensive task for our database because the database has to check if the collection exists. And if it doesn't exist, it has to create the collection. So actually, this is a very inefficient part of code because although we're always using the same collection, we get it every time. So let's fix this code with a global variable. So let's type var user collection and it's of type mongo.collection. And now instead of global.database.collectionUser, we're simply going to use user collection.findOne. And we have to do it for all our methods. So we can actually hit Ctrl Z. And now hit Ctrl F in order to find all occurrences. And we want to replace the occurrences, so let's hit Ctrl H. And this code should be replaced by user collection. Then hit Enter until all occurrences are replaced. And that's it. Of course, we aren't fully done yet, because this line of code just declares the variable, but it isn't initialized. So in our main function, where is it? It's here. We can say user collection equals global.database.collection and the name of the collection is user. As you can see, we get an error, because the collection returns a pointer, but our variable has a value type and there is no pointer. So we have to dereference the pointer by placing a star in front of global. And now our code works. So this simple improvement will make our code a lot faster, because this function is only executed once. And then the value of this code is stored in user collection. And otherwise, we would get the user collection every time here, here, and here. So we just made a massive performance improvement. In order to make our changes take effect, we need to restart our service. So I'm going to hit Ctrl C and hit the arrow up in order to execute the last executed command and hit Enter. And again, allow the access to the firewall. And if we now check if our methods still work, I will just log out and log in again as John42 with example, and hit the login button, and we can see it still works. Great. In the last episode, I made a mistake. So if we open up our gRPC file, namely our services.proto file, we can see that our auth service has these functions email used and username used. But actually, we're never using these functions from our front end. And that's the mistake I made. So at signup.js, we have these validation functions which are here. So this is the password validation function. This is the email validation function. And here we have the username validation function. And actually, at the end of these functions, we also want to check if the username or the email is already used. To do so, we have to import the requests. So let's type import. And actually, we need a lot to import here. So we want to import auth service from, and actually it's also imported from the app, so we can combine it. We want to import router and auth service. Sorry, auth client. Just like that. And what else do we need to import? We need to import something from dot dot slash proto slash services underscore grpc underscore web underscore pb. And here we simply import a signup request, the auth user request, and we also import username used request and email used request. If you don't know where these things come from, they are defined in our proto file. As you can see, these are the messages. So now let's scroll down until we reach the username validation function. And if the length of the username is okay, we want to check if the username is already used. To do so, let's type let request equals new username used request, and here we can call request.setUsername, and you want to set it to username. Now we can simply call auth client.usernameUsed, and here we have our requests. Then the metadata, which is an empty JSON object. And here we have error and response. And if we have an error, we simply want to return alert error.message. And if we don't have an error, we can say if response.getUsed, and as you can see, our used response has a boolean value called used. So this getUsed will either be true or false, and if it is true, we want to set our username error dot inner text to the string this username is already in use. Please choose another. And then we also want to return, just as above. Now let's test if it works. So let's save the file and open up our signup page. And if now type John 42 here, we see this username is already in use. Please choose another. Great. So now we have to do the same thing for our email. So open up VS Code again and scroll down to the email validation function, which is here. And it's actually pretty the same code. We create a new request, but now it's of type email used request. And we want to call request.setEmail, and we set the email to email. And now we can simply call auth client.emailUsed and our request, an empty JSON object, and our callback, which takes error and response. And if we have an error, we want to return alert error.message, And if we don't have an error, we can again say if rest.getUsed. We want to set email error dot inner text to something like this email is already in use. Please choose another. And then we want to return. Save the file and let's test if also this worked. So let's try john@gmail.com. And we get this email is already in use. Please choose another. Great. So now we want to make sure that it really works. So let's try again signing up as john42. And we see the error, which is great. And if you sign up as john422, the error is gone. And as email, let's use john@gmail.com. And we get the error. But if you use @gmail.co.uk, the error is gone. And as password, I'm going to use example. And let's hit sign up. And as you can see, it worked perfectly fine. At the end of this episode, I'd like to thank everyone who left a nice comment under my video. It really means a lot to me. I hope I'll find the time to upload more frequently in the future. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, comment, and hopefully see you next time.